This tutorial will show you how to install the C and C++ compiler and tools so that you can compile on your Windows 7, Windows 8, Windows 8.1, and Windows 10 operating systems. This will focus mainly on the 64-bit, but will also work for 32-bit systems as well. So go ahead, open up your browser, and in a new tab, load this address right here. Scroll on down to installing and setting up the compilers and tools. Next, what you're going to do is you're going to open up a new tab and go to cygwin.com and then click on the install Cygwin. Next, you have a choice between installing your 32-bit version or your 64-bit. If you're on a 64-bit version, please install 64-bit. Download the file. I've already got a copy downloaded. And then once it's downloaded, double-click on the setup, run the setup, click Next, install from Internet. The root directory is fine. You can install it in program files. This does not lock you into place like some applications do, requiring you to install only in the C or only in the program files. I'm using all users. Choose your preferences. Click Next. Just leave it as local directory for now. We're actually going to move this folder when we've finally installed all the packages necessary. Click Next. I'm going to use Direct Connection because that's what I have set up at the moment, or you can change your proxy. Choose any mirror, doesn't matter. Click Next. Let it download. After it's downloaded and installed and set up, the package window will look like the following. Click on Pending if you only see Pending. You probably will see Full because I've already installed, but you haven't. Click on Category, then switch back to your browser. Switch back to the installing and configuration URL. And then what we're going to type in is gcc-core. So you can either copy and paste that or type it in. I'm going to go ahead and type it in, gcc-core. And then select default install. Next, we're going to type in just C++. So C++, same thing before, development install. And then we're going to type in gdb. But what you're going to do instead is you're going to go to full and type in gdb. And then you're going to find the GNU debugger or GNU debugger, however you say it. And then make sure you install it. Mine's got keep on it because I've already installed, but you should see the word keep. Or sorry, you should see the word install. Next, what you're going to type in is the word make. And then scrolling down to the word make. Just make, nothing else special. So we have the word right here, make, the GNU version of the make utility. So I'm going to click keep. You'll want to set up install on it. And then go ahead and click next, and it'll run through about roughly between 5 and 15 minutes, depending on your system, for installing the packages. Do not install all packages because that's roughly around, I believe somebody said, 8 gigabytes on the web. And that's just ridiculous for compiling a C or C++ program. So go ahead and run through that. Next, what we're going to do is we're going to set our global environment variables. So go ahead, go into your C directory and find where you installed Cygwin. Then go in the bin directory, copy the path to that directory, go to your system or your advanced system variables. I right-click on my Windows icon. Click on System, Advanced System Settings, Environment Variables, and then under System Variables, locate the path, click Edit, and then notice I've already got mine set in after my last, which is my JDK installation, and then go ahead and paste in your bin directory for the Cygwin, add a semicolon, click OK, click OK, click OK again, and then go ahead and close that out. Next, what you're going to want to do is notice I have my setup.x86 install. So from your downloads directory where you have your install, go ahead and cut this and paste it right into this directory. Do the same thing with that mirror that we downloaded. Go ahead and cut that and put that in here as well. The reason why you want the setup in here is because the setup runs the same way as an update does. So anytime you want to update anything, you'll double click and run through the setup and you can update from there. Now that the environment variables are set up, go ahead and close out Cygwin 64. You can hide your downloads, it doesn't matter. I'm going to minimize my browser windows. Oh, actually, sorry, I'm going to bring those back up, because now what we're going to do is we're going to scroll down and check to make sure Cygwin has been installed. You may have to restart your computer, and you may not have to. I'm actually using for my command prompt, which you're going to have to load up, is commander.net, which is a syntax highlighting version of the command console. So go ahead and load up your command console, and then go ahead and copy in the first one and paste it, and then run it. And if you get the version number, you know you installed it correctly. Do the same thing for the rest. And then once you're done, go ahead and clear that out. Now I'm going to show you that you can compile it now that it's proof that it's actually installed. So I'm going to change my directory to a location where I have C files. And we're going to actually run hello.c. So I'm using Sublime Text Editor with the C Improved package installed for that, so it actually does additional highlighting syntax. And all it's going to do is print hello world to the screen. So go ahead and type gcc-o, and then the name of the file you want to call it. So I'm going to call it hello, and then the name of the actual file that we are going to compile, which is hello.c. Oops. Click on it. Notice that we now have hello.exe added. So we type hello.exe. Hello world. Thanks for watching.